Good morning everyone, I am Srinivas from IT department from St. Martin's Engineering College. Today we are going to discuss a small topic on data structures and we'll see how to, we have different types of data structures in this one, we'll see one by one. So first of all, what we are going to do this one, what is a data structure? Data is nothing but a raw data. And what is structure? We need to keep in a proper manner, proper position, right? So by these two words, we can say that data structure is a way of organizing the data in a proper manner. Organizing data in a proper manner. By this data, while we are organizing this data, we can have a work efficiently. We can work efficiently when we are going to organize. So these are two purposes of these data structures. In this data structure, we have different types of data structures. Like it is classified into again two types. The first one is called as linear data structure, and the second one is called as non-linear data structure. We'll see how the classification will goes on. So this classification of data structure is classified into two types. The first one is called as linear data structure. This is a linear data structure, and this is non-linear data structure. So it is classified into two types, linear and non-linear. Again, this linear data structure is classified into again different types. The very first one can be called as a stack. And the second one is called as a queue. And the third one is called as linked list. And the fourth one is called as arrays. So this is a classification of linear data structure. And the non-linear data structure is classified into again two types. The first one is called as a graph, and the second one is called as a trees. So this is a classification of data structures. We are going to see about only stacks in this linear data structures today. So how it works, what is the implementation of these stacks, we will see one by one. We are talking about stacks. This stacks is nothing but it is a linear data structure. This is a linear data structure that follows LIFO. We can say that follows LIFO. What is the abbreviation LIFO? Nothing but last in, first out. Last in, first out. First out. So last in, first out. So general example for this one, when we go to any restaurant, we have the place has been washed out. This is a dish. We can say that this is a stack. In that we have number of plates, right? Number of plates are there. The last plate which has been entered, that will be removed first. So last in, whatever the last plate that has been put into the stack, that will be removed first. That is example of LIFO, last in, first out, right? We'll see in this stacks we have different types of operations in these stacks, right? So we can say that the last element added into the stack will be removed first, right? The last element added. Suppose we have added element called as A. A is added into the stack, right? Added into stack, that will be removed first. So this is the observation of last in first out. That is the meaning of stacks. And we have different types of operations in this stack. Now, what are the operations? We have operations like operations in stack. The first one is called as push operation, the second one is called as pop, and third one is called as display, and fourth one you can use count, and fifth one is empty, and sixth one is full. These are the general operations when you are using a stacks. So we will see one by one what is a push operation, what is a pop operation, and what is, we will see one by one. So push is nothing but inserting element. What is the meaning of this push? Pushing nothing but inserting element into the stack. Suppose we have this is a stack. Think that this is a stack. We are talking about the first one is called as push. So I want to push element called as push A. I want to push the element called as push A. When you are pushing element, you are inserting element. Push nothing but inserting. We have a condition that whether the stack is full or not, we need to check when you are inserting any element. So what is the condition for this push operation? Check whether the stack is full or not. Check whether stack is full or not. So this is a condition when you want to check when you are inserting any element into the stack. So if the stack is full, we'll get an error called as stack is overflow. If the stack is full, we'll get a message called as stack is overflow. So whenever you want to insert element, the stack should be empty. Right? So if you want to define some stack size is 5. Think that 5 is the stack size. So in this stack we have a element called as the topmost element, can be called as a top here. Top. Right? So the end, we can say that the end is called as top of the stack. So we want to insert element. First, the first stack is put in a top equal minus 1. Top equal to minus 1. This is a top equal to minus 1. Then only we can insert the element into the stack. Right? So first, what is the end of the top end is here. Top equal to minus 1. Right? If you want to insert one element, this is normal top equal to minus 1. If you want to insert one element, top equal to minus 1. So insert first, insert the element like first we want to insert, add the top equal top plus 1, right? First, the second element is this one, top equal to top plus 1. So already we have an element called as, the value of top is minus 1. So minus 1 is minus 1 plus 1 is 0. So the top value is 0. So the space will be allocated into the stack. So then only we can insert the element. So push A is, the A will be inserted into the stack. So the top value is this one, top equal to 0. Like that, we need to insert one by one. I want to insert one more element like push of B. Then the top value will be incremented by 1. The top value will be incremented by 1. The second element is, already we have an element top equal to 0. In the second element, allocate the memory for the second element. Push of B. Right? For this push of B, again top equal to top plus 1. So already we have the value is 0. 0 plus 1 is 1. So the 1 will be allocated into the top. The top equal to 1. So whatever the value we want to insert into the stack will be inserted. right? Inserted, like B will be inserted. Allocate the memory first for the stack, insert the elements, right? Then increment the top value by 1 by 1. Like this, we need to insert 1 by 1 elements. Suppose I want to insert the 5 elements, like A, B, C, D, right? These are the 4 elements. The last element is 5. So 5 elements. 5 elements has been inserted into the stack. After 5 elements, so you want to insert the element, the F element. So what happens? I told you that check whether stack is full or not. I have given condition here. So if the stack is full, it gives a message called as stack is overflow. So the size of the stack is already 5. Like this is 0, this is 1, this is 1, 2, 3, 4. The size of the stack is 5. We want to insert one more element, F. So it gives an error called as stack is overflow. Right? This is a push operation. Like that, you need to check when you want to insert any element. The next one is called as pop. The next element is called as pop. The next element is called as pop. Here pop is nothing but removing or deleting an element. So we need to delete an element from the stack, right? First, already we have seen that we have inserted the 5 elements into the stack, like A, B, C, D, E. We have inserted 5 elements. The top end is called as this here. This is pointing towards the element here, right? We want to delete the element. We want to pop the element of E. We can write pop of E. Pop of E. What happens? The first, remove this one. Remove the space for this one. Top equal to top minus 1. Right? Remove the space for this one. Automatically that element will be removed, right? So top equal to top minus 1. Already we have a top value is, this is 0, 1, 2, 3, this is 4. So the pointing towards the element E, the top is 4, 4 minus 1 is 3. So first remove the top equal top minus 1. The value is, top value is 3. Then remove this one. Automatically the element which is inserted already there in this stack will be removed automatically. Like this, we need to remove 1 by 1 using the top equal top minus 1, right? Up to this, all elements will be removed. This is top equal to top minus 1. Lastly, after removing this element A, top equal to top minus 1, the value will be top equal to top minus 1. Top equal to minus 1, right? After removing all elements, what happens? Whenever you want to remove the elements, we'll get a message called as stack is underflow. Stack is underflow means what? The stack is empty. We cannot remove the elements, or stack is empty. These are the conditions. When you want to insert any, when you want to remove any elements from the stack, check whether the stack is empty or not. If the stack is empty, you will get a message called as stack is underflow. Right? These are the two conditions. Push and pop are the two operations, and the third one is called as display operation. Display operation is used to display all the elements which are in the stack, whether the removed, what are the elements which are removed and what are the elements which are inserted. It displays one by one and all elements in the stack. And the third operation is display. Display used for what are the elements inserted in the stack and what are the elements deleted in the stack. Inserting all the elements, it displays information about all elements in stack. And the next one, the fourth one is count. The count operation is used to display all the, what are the elements, how many count are there. It displays the counting of all the elements. And fifth one is empty. Is empty used for whether the stack is empty or not, displays information of this stack. empty or not. And the sixth one is full. Display support the stack is full or not. Full or not. These are the things displays about all the stacks operations, right? So in the next topic, in the next class, we'll discuss about the queues. Thank you.